Everybody, was good YouTube? How you guys doing today? It's me, T Judd. Hope you're good and hope the market is trading you well. Before I start, I'd love to say please trade carefully and stay careful. Be careful, so lot of scammers are outside now in the space, so lot, man. Don't share your seed with anybody, don't share your past with anybody. Pending that, may the pump be with us. So yeah, so basically today we're just going to talk about what we started already, and that's the Arbitrum Odyssey. I made a video on that a month ago, so today we're just going to check out the summary of everything because it has started already. So I'm trying to make this as brief as possible, you feel me? So all the links that I'll be using today is going to be in the description below. You can come check it out, but we're only going to read through the frequently asked questions. So any other thing, you have to come with them yourself. So let's just check it out real quick. So on the Arbitrum page, make sure you're following them on Twitter. You can come up on here, read everything all through. Just to make this as brief as possible and not to get you guys bored. So so this is Olympia. I think it's the only one we can just check out real quick. Recap, it's an 8-week event where users can get NFTs by completing on-chain actions in Arbitrum. There are 17 Arbitrum NFTs on Bridge Week, 2 on Bridge Week, 14 on the next 7 weeks. One bonus NFT if you collect 13/16. So everything on here you would understand it better if you viewed my last video on this Arbitrum Odyssey. So basically this first week is the bridging week, and then we can actually get 2 NFTs, one from trading from bridging to Ethereum to the Arbitrum chain, and 2 for using the most bridge protocol. Is that right? Yeah, for using the most bridge platform for this event. So aside that, you can just come on here, read everything yourself. All right, these are all the protocols, these are all the platforms to be used. So what happened here is he actually explained all the platforms that have token and those that does not have token yet. So for me, I'll be using this Bungie.exchange. Sounds funny, but I actually did test on them, and it's fun and actually more faster than any other protocol. So they don't have a token yet, they are still on that testnet. So why bridging my Ethereum from any other chain to Arbitrum to qualify for the NFT? Now, to get my Ethereum out of the Arbitrum chain, I'll be using this Bungie. Okay, I'm gonna call it Bungie. Yeah, I'll be using this Bungie. So let's just dive right into the video. So this I'll be dropping the link in the description below where you can trace and track down the statistics and the data of everything currently happening in the Odyssey. This is statistics of everything happening for the first week. So over here you check out platforms where people are using, where the most bridge protocols are, and the nearest to and the nearest to, and you know, like that, the whole data is available. Yeah, you can come over here, read everything on it. Yeah, so let's just dive into this. All right, so this Project Galaxy, let me just refresh the page real quick. All right, so I'll be connecting my wallet. So from here we'll get to know everything we're gonna be doing to qualify for the NFT. Alright, so this is the Arbitrum Odyssey. Enter. These are the platforms we can use to bridge into the Arbitrum chain. But right over here, I have my Ethereum on the Optimism network. So I'll be using Hope.exchange, Hope Optimism. Should we use Hope? I think Hope already did airdrop already. Okay. Hope already did airdrop already. but they are the most used platform. So to qualify for the first NFT, you have to use the most used. So based on everything you're gonna be reading here, you have to use the most used platform. So real quick, let's just check out the most frequently asked question about the Arbitrum Odyssey. So instead of us reading all through all that, let's just read only the frequently asked questions so that we can get to understand it, you feel me? So okay, when does the Odyssey begin? That was yesterday, June 21st. Are there any requirements to participate? Only Ethereum to pay for gas fee. Can I participate if I didn't vote on the snapshot? Yeah, you can participate. Should I do anything now to prepare? No, okay. So I think it's for the previous frequently asked questions. So let's just use the recent one. What assets can be counted during Bridge Week? Only Ethereum can be counted. So whatsoever you're gonna be doing for the Odyssey, make sure it's Ethereum. So only Ethereum can be used. Is there a minimum amount of Ethereum I should be bridging? No minimum amount. So you can use any lowest amount in case you don't have much funds, but at the same time make sure to have gas fee in consideration. How can I qualify for the bonus NFT during Bridge Week? Use the one brick that you think we have the most Ethereum bridge by the end of the week, and we already checked that out already, and we'll be checking it again, which is going to be op.exchange. When can claim my bridging NFT? Shortly after Bridge Weekends. Alright, so just like that, that's everything about it. You can come to the Discord on page to read everything about it. So let's just get right back into it. So over here, as you can see, op.exchange have the most bridge Ethereum to the Arbitrum chain, op.exchange. So I'll be dropping the link in the description. You can come over here to check it out to read real quick. So after that, I think we have across, then we have seller, blah blah blah. So let's just be quick over here. You can come here and click. This is where you also confirm if your account has been accredited and if you are eligible for the NFT, because once we are done over here, it will change green, it will change to color green. So let's just get right into the video. Let's dive right into the video. Okay, let me refresh page. I think this is my previous wallet. Alright, we'll be connecting. I think the network is a little bit slow today. Alright, I think we have 1.37. So basically I'll be using 1.35 Ethereum. I'm using 1.35 Ethereum. I don't know how much that will be in dollars, but I think it's gonna be above $1,000. So I'll be sending that from the Optimism chain to the Arbitrum chain. Now remember, the goal is to transfer to the Arbitrum chain, and the main goal is to use the most platform that has the most bridge Ethereum. So I'll send. It's gonna take just few minutes or few seconds, but it's not gonna take a lot of your time. So we just have to confirm transaction. So just gas fee is gonna be just 29 cents, not that much. So big time, yeah, completed. Just gonna take a few minutes. So it's pending. Alright, make sure to like, subscribe, join my channel. If you have any question, let me know. A little bit of bonus if you think you don't have much funds. If you think you don't have funds to get this shit done, join my channel, let me know. I'm thinking we can actually like crowdfund for those who don't have for those who don't have funds to bridge or to bridge to the Arbitrum chain. Just join my channel and let me know so that we'll find solution for you, because we're trying to help everybody qualify for the possible airdrop, you feel me? So that's gonna be like a really bonus for me to you guys. But please, before you do, just in case not to run away with funds and all, it would be better if you have a verified Binance account, I think. Yeah, a verified one, so that will not kill you for real and you trusted. So we're done with that. Yeah, so that's all to qualify for the sorry, for the first NFT. So let's just confirm if our wallet is eligible for the first NFT. Let's just confirm. Like I said earlier on, it's a turn green. Alright. So now our wallet is eligible. So now we've used the most used platform to bridge to the Arbitrum chain. And we've also bridged to the Arbitrum chain. So now we're moving our funds. Just in case you want to remove your funds from the Arbitrum chain, this is actually not necessary. But based on everything Olip said here, listing platforms that already have token and those that does not have token, and under it we have the Bungi dot exchange. They don't have a token and they are currently still under beta. So that's going to be a very big catch for us, for we that for any future possible airdrop, we don't know. We just assuming our hope is going to be worth it. So let's just connect our wallet. Let's just connect our wallet. Then we're going to bridge our funds from the Arbitrum chain back to the Optimism chain. That's for those that does not want to leave their funds under the Arbitrum chain. So I'll be picking the let me just keep this here. So I'll be picking the Arbitrum chain. Then I'll be bridging back to Optimism, Ethereum. I'll need it in Ethereum. Yeah, so max I think this is going to be about $1,000. So that we are using one stone to key two beds. At the same time, we are accumulating a TVL of $1,000 plus. And at the same time, we are trying to interact with the platform. Bungi is new, I think. Yeah, they are still under beta. Gas fee is just 33 cents. Okay, fair enough. So I'll proceed. And they're actually very, very fast. I actually did test on it before now just to make sure. Alright. I think we're 13 minutes into the video. I'm trying to be fast. I'm trying to be very, very fast. Or 13 or 11 minutes, not too sure. Alright, so bridge. Please, if you have any question, let me know in the channel. Let me know in the channel. I'm always online, willing to help everybody. Just let me know your question. Alright, confirm. Confirm. Alright, it's loading. So yeah, guys, make sure to share the videos to your loved ones. Like, subscribe. If you don't have much funds to bridge, let me know so that we'll find solution for everyone who don't have much funds. But it's going to be for the first few set of users. Like I said earlier, I probably not mentioned it, we can't help everybody in the world, you feel me? So it's going to be for the first few users. Yeah, it's going to be for the first few users. All right we're still waiting for the transaction to be completed, so we have our funds back to the Ethereum chain. So basically, that's all. We've used the most used platform on Arbitrum. That's for the second NFT, and for the first NFT, we bridged Ethereum from any other chain to the Arbitrum chain, and that's the main goal. Remember, everything you are doing is meant to be on the Ethereum chain. Everything you are doing is meant to be on the Ethereum chain, and we've also interacted with Bungi, which is still on that testnet. And we've also used a TVL of over $1,000. So we're currently using two stone to key. So we're using one stone to key. No, we're using one stone to key three beds. So the three beds are one bridging to the Arbitrum chain, two using the most bridge platform, and three interacting with Bungi. So yeah, that's all for now. Thanks for staying on with me, guys. I really do appreciate you all. Please stay safe, tread carefully. May the gains be with us all. And don't forget to like, subscribe, share the video to your loved ones. If you're gonna support the channel, my address will be in the description below. Do so. If you want to support those who don't have funds also to bridge, that's the best time to. Alright guys, pending my next video, which is going to be next week on the next Arbitral Modise week 2. Please stay safe. Alright guys, peace out. Yeah, gang.